Hello, this is Lazarus at Telecom Tech, where telecom and networking technologies are simply explained. Today, we'll be simply explaining the pushing, swapping, and popping of MPLS labels. As always, don't forget to subscribe, enable notifications, and like this video if you like this video. And if you have questions or feedback, please write them in the comments below. I'm always happy to read them and to respond. Last time, we took a closer look at how LDP operates within the framework of MPLS. In this video, we'll take a look at the mechanisms involved in adding, switching, and removing LDP labels. In MPLS terminology, this is called pushing, swapping, and popping labels. Now, it's important to understand the fundamentals of this process now, because in later videos, we'll be talking about how MPLS interacts with other features such as layer 3 VPNs. In these cases, you can have label stacks where you can push multiple labels onto a packet to provide traffic segmentation based on customer networks. We'll talk more about that in a future video, but to understand these concepts, we'll first need to know how pushing, swapping, and popping labels takes place. Here we have two customer devices, CE1 and CE2, and we have an MPLS infrastructure that's being used by the ISP to interconnect these two sites. In our scenario, some host on the 192.168.11.0/24 network is sending data to the 192.168.12.0/24 network. Remember, the CE routers know nothing about MPLS, so they're going to send their data based on the routing protocol that's being run between the CE and PE routers here. So the packet arrives at PE1. PE1 looks at the destination IP address and does a lookup in its LFIB. It sees that the local label is 101 and the outgoing label of the next hop node, which is P1, is 201. Now, at this point, I'd like to say a few words about the actual label values. The label is a 20-bit field within the MPLS header. Label values 0 to 15 are reserved for special purposes and cannot be assigned to specific prefixes. If you're interested in finding out more about those reserved labels, take a look at a link to the related RFC in the description below. So by default, in most vendor implementations, LDP labels for MPLS are assigned starting with a value of 16. This is certainly the case for Cisco devices, while other vendors may choose a different implementation. Since labels are locally significant, it doesn't really matter what actual values are used. So if you leave all configurations at their default, you will most likely see that the same label is being used by multiple routers along the path. Now, because we humans need some way to differentiate between the actions taken by each node in the path, it's always a good idea to change this default behavior such that we can more easily determine which labels are assigned by which nodes. For example, you can make PE1 here use a range of labels from 100 to 199. Make P1 here use a range of labels from 200 to 299. And P2 to use a range of 300 to 399, and so on. And you can do that for all their label assignments. That way, you can know which node generated which label. For now, let's say that we've already done this for our topology. In a later video, when we get into configurations, we'll show how this is actually implemented. For now, let's take a look at what the PE1 node does with this packet. As it sends the packet out, it will push a label onto it. Remember, pushing means adding a label. Specifically, label 201 is pushed. You can see that value in the outgoing label column of the LFIB in PE1. How did PE1 know to push that label? Because P1 shared with PE1 that its label for that particular network is 201. We can also see the exit interface as well as the next hop IP of P1 within the LFIB. Remember, that the next hop IP is the IP addressing that's used in the underlay network that supports the MPLS infrastructure. Now, if we look inside the MPLS header, we'll see that label 201 has been added or pushed into the appropriate field. Now, you'll note that PE1 here has a local label for the 192.168.12.0/24 network. That local label is actually never pushed onto the packet in this specific scenario. This is because the PE1 router is the first MPLS router that is encountered along the path. So that label is never pushed. Only the remote label, that is, the label advertised by P1, is pushed in order to forward the packet appropriately. However, as we will see later on, this label will be used when MPLS is employed with layer 3 VPNs. But at this point, I digress. Let's go on to what we're looking at in this video. So that was label pushing. Now P1 will take a look at its own LFIB and will find the destination prefix and will see that the defined outgoing label is 301. We also see the exit interface and the next hop IP of P2 of the underlay network, which is actually our next hop node. This label and the additional information was learned via LDP. So P1 will perform label swapping at this point. It will remove its own label of 201, which is how the packet arrived, and it will swap it with the remote label or outgoing label for this particular destination, which is 301. And it will send it to P2, which is the next hop node. Now, once the packet reaches the P2 router, it will look up the destination in the LFIB, and it will see an outgoing label of pop label. This is the penultimate hop popping process that we talked about in the previous video. The last P router in the path, which in this case is P2, will pop the label, or in other words, remove the label, before it is sent to the final PE router, which is PE2. As you can see, the MPLS header here is removed completely during the popping process, and thus the data arrives at PE2 with no label. That means that PE2 here will simply use traditional routing to get that packet to the destination, which is behind this CE2 router here. So that covers the fundamentals of label pushing, swapping, and popping, all fundamental operations found within MPLS. I hope you found this video useful, and if you have, please click that thumbs up button. If you have any questions, feel free to leave a comment, and please subscribe to get updates to newly published videos. I'm Lazarus at Telecom Tech. I hope this has been helpful for you, and I'd like to thank you for watching.